Hello everyone, welcome to Unacademy. It's Bharat Gupta and this session is for CAT Quant number system previous year question from 76 to 80. We have covered several chapters with concept and with practice question. To watch all these chapters, download Unacademy learning app from Play Store. Enjoy each and every session discussed by me and other educator. So let us start with CAT previous year number system question from 76 to 80. Now, in this session, we start with question number 76 to 80. Now, the question 76 that we'll discuss in this lesson is, if the sum of first 11 terms of an arithmetic progression equals that of the first 19 terms, then what is the sum of the first 30 terms? Okay. Next question, 77. On January 1, 2004, two new societies S1 and S2 are formed, each with N members. On the first day of each subsequent month, S1 adds B member while S2 multiply its current number of members by constant factor R. Both the societies have the same number of member on July 2, 2004. If B is equal to 10.5N, what is the value of R? Question asked in CAT 2004 and options are 2, 1.9, 1.8, 1.7. Question number 78. Let y is equal 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 3 plus 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 3 plus so on. What is the value of n? CAT 2004 question, options are this. Now next question. The remainder when 15 to the power 23 plus 23 to the power 23 divided by 19. CAT 2004 question, option A 5, 4, B 15, C 0, D 18. Question number 80. Consider the sequence of number A1, A2, A3 up to infinity, where A1 is 81.33 and A2 is minus 19. AJ is equal AJ minus 1 minus AJ minus 2 for J greater than or equal to 3. What is the sum of first 6002 terms of this sequence? CAT 2004 question, option minus 100.33, B option minus 30.00, C option 62.33 and D option 119.33. So, question number 76, if the sum of first 11 terms of arithmetic progression equals that of the first 19 terms, then what is the sum of the first 30 terms of the series? Okay, so we know that it is given that sum of 11 terms is equal to sum of first 19 terms. So using formula for sum, 11 terms sum would be 11 by 2, 2a plus 11 minus 1, d or 10d. For 19 terms, this sum would be 19 by 2, 2a plus 18d, right? Now, with this condition, 2 cancelled. Now multiply this, this would be 22a, this would be 110d. Now 19 to the 38a and this is 342d. Now take everything this side, 38a minus 22a would be 16a and this is 232d. Now if we take 8 common, this would be 2a plus 29d and if we divide 8 this side, it would be 2a plus 29d is equal 0. Now we have to calculate sum of 30 terms, right? So sum of 30 terms, 30 by 2, 2a plus 29d, and as we calculated earlier in this case, 2a plus 29d is 0, so this would be 0. So answer of this question is A option, right? 0. Easy question. You have to remember this formula. If you know this formula, sum of n terms, this question would be very easy. Now the next question, on January 1, 2004, two new societies S1 and S2 are framed, each with N member. On the first day of each subsequent month, S1 adds B members while S2 multiply its current number of members by constant factor R. Both the societies have the same number of member on July 2, 2004. If B is equal 10.5N, what is the value of R? Now this question asked in CAT 2004 solution. See, it is given that in case of S1 society, 1st January 2004, there are number of member is n, and on 2nd July 2004 there are 6 months and it is multiplied by a factor b. It added b members every year, every month, so number of member 2nd July 2004 would be n in plus 6b. And in case of S2, it is given that it multiply the number by r, so 1st January 2004 members are n, so 2nd July 2004 there are 6 months, so number of member would be nr6. Now it is given that on 2nd July members are equal, right? So n plus 6b, this is member in S1 society, is equal to nr6. right? And it is also given that value of B is 10.5n, right? See, that value of B is given as 10.5n. Now put value of 6 B as 10.5n, this would be 63n, and now 63n plus n would be 64n. 64n is equal nr to the power 6. Now nn get cancelled, so r to the power 6 is 64, so r would be 2. So answer of this question is 2. So the question is very interesting. Important part is this, that we have 6 months, so it would be added by 6b and it would be multiplied by r to the power 6, and our answer is 2. Answer is B option. Next question. Now this is a series question in which there is an infinite series is given. So the important part in this case is, see, we have given with a series which contain y 1 by 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1 upon so on. First of all, observe the options. First of all, our answer should be less than, or our answer should be less than 1. So this option, because root 3 is somewhere around 3 point something, and minus 3, it would be less than this. See, this root 13 plus 3, this is 3 point something plus 3, 6 by 2 would be 3 point something. And same way, this answer is also 3 point something. So these two A and C is not possible. Why? Because in our question, 1 upon something, and 1 upon something is always less than 1. So possibility is for B and D, right? The point is this, in this case, humne ye check kiya, हमारा जो y है, y is 1 upon something, तो 1 upon something is always less than 1. So by checking the option, root 13 plus 3 by 2 is greater than 1, right? Or it is 3 point something, because root 13 is 3 point something, 3 plus 3 is 6 point something, divided by 2 is 3 point something. So these two option cancel. Now we have remaining with B and D. So now what is the question? Question is y is equal 1 upon 2 plus this. Now you can see that this is 1 upon 2 and then 1 upon 3. Now it start again with this part. So if we neglect this part, or if we neglect this upper part, this will again be y. So what we can do, we can write this entire portion 1 upon 2 plus 1 plus 3 plus y. This is 3 plus y. Now solving, if we take 3 plus y LCM, it is 6 plus 2y plus 1, and when we further simplify, it would be y is equal 3 plus y upon 7 plus 2y, right? Now this, if we take 7 plus 2y this side, it would be 7y plus 2y square is equal 3 plus y. Now take 3 plus y this side, it would be 2y square plus 6y minus 3 equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation. Now in this case, a is 2, b is 6, and c is minus 3 using Sridharacharya. So if we use Sridharacharya, this is minus b plus minus root b square minus 4ac 2a. As we already discussed that answer would be in terms of minus, so neglecting plus sign. Now this is printing error, take it as plus sign. So neglect plus sign. So use all, in this case, minus sign. Right? See, this is plus sign, and when we use this minus this side, we'll neglect minus sign. Right, this is correct. Neglect minus sign, so we have plus sign with this minus sign, right? Now put the value of a, b is 6, b square is 6, square 36, and 4 into 2 into minus 3 upon 2 into 2. Solving, we get minus 6 plus root 60 by 4. This is 2 root 15 minus 6 by 4, and now cancel it by 2, right? So root 15 initial and then minus 3. So our answer is y is equal root 15 minus 3. So the important part in this case, first of all, we have decided that these two options are not possible. So we'll neglect minus sign, because if we take minus sign, both would be negative, right? And there is no option which contain all part negative. So we have to take positive sign. So we'll neglect minus sign. So our answer would be this D option, right? Next question. Now the remainder went 15 to the power 23 plus 23 to the power 23 divided by 19. So this is very interesting and easy question. See, we know that x plus y to the power n is divisible by x plus y if n is odd. And how to remember this condition? You should remember this formula, x cube plus y cube is equal x plus y x square minus xy plus y square. अगर आपको ये फॉर्मूला लर्न है तो आपको पता होना चाहिए कि अगर यहाँ पर पावर ऑड है, क्यूब है, इट कंटेन x plus y. So by this you can memorize this formula as x to the power n plus y to the power n is divisible by x plus y if n is odd. So in this case, 15 to the power 23, 23 to the power 23, power is odd and same. So it is divisible by 15 plus 23 or 38 or 19. So when this number divided by 19, remainder would be 0, C option. right? Next question. Okay, consider the sequence of number A1, A2, A3 up to infinity, where A1 is 81.33 and A2 is minus 19 and AJ is equal AJ minus 1 minus AJ minus 2 for J is greater than or equal to 3. What is the sum of first 6002 terms of this sequence? See friends, if we calculate entire 602 term, then it would be very difficult question. So we have to find some pattern in this. So the pattern would be, so we have given with A1 as 81.3, A2 as minus 19, and now AJ is AJ minus 1, AJ minus 2. Now put J as 3, it would be A2 minus A1. Now A2 is 81.3, put this value at later stage. So A2 minus A1, this is A3. Now A4 would be A3 minus A2. Now A3 is what? A2 minus A1, now A2 cancel, this is minus A1. Now A5 would be A4 minus A3. Now A4 is what? Minus A1, and A3 is minus, A3 is this. So take minus, this would be minus, this would be plus, A1 cancel, now it is minus A2. Now A6 would be A5 minus A4, right? Or A5 is what? Minus A2, or A4 is minus A1. Now put this, we have minus A2 plus A1. Now A7 would be A6 minus A5, right? Now put value of A6, which is minus A2 plus A1, and A2 cancel, this is A1. Now A8 is A7 minus A2. So after A6, you can see that it is again repeating. A7 is A1 and A2 is A8 is A2, and so on. If we calculate A9, it would be this, right? So the pattern in this case is after 6 terms, it will repeat itself. So if we add A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, all value, or A6, all value would be cancelled. So sum of first 6 term will give us 0, and as we can calculate it, 7 term would be same as A1 and 8 term is same as A2. So 8 term would be same as A3. 9 term. So we can say the sum of 6 term is 0, or next 6 term is 0. So sum of 6000 terms should also be 0. So 6002 terms that we have to calculate. Humko calculate karna hai kya? 6002 terms ka sum. So in this case we can write this as 6002 terms sum is 6000 terms plus S2. After this 6000 term, it will again start with A1, A2. So this sum is 0, right? So this is 0, and this S2 would be A1 plus A2. And now A1 is what? 81.33 minus 19. So our answer is 62.33. Answer is C option. Now this is very interesting question. For these type of question, you have to find such type of pattern, otherwise you are not able to solve this question. So finding pattern is very important. Okay, so this is what we have, 76 to 80 question. In the next session, we'll discuss some more question on number system, and we'll continue this series till we'll complete all the question asked till 2017 exam. Right, keep watching, keep sharing. If you like, comment. If you have any problem, you can write it on comment box. All the best for your examination.